We did bagels, and they were like, bagels, can you bring me bagels? Is he still there? We didn't have, it was just a little tiny store. We didn't like plan on any of this being this long or being expanding. It just happened slowly.
In my heart, I have but one desire.
Oh my God, this is Christmas decoration. Okay. My name is Francine Eubanks, and I'm the owner of Bagel King. I have a partner. His name is Mark Lemelin. And we've been here 30 years. My father opened Bagel King in 1977 in Winter Park, and my sisters and I all worked for him growing up. And after probably in the early 80s, I went to college and I taught school for a while. And then I taught in Deltona here, and I realized how many New Yorkers lived in Deltona and how we didn't have any bagel stores out here. So I asked my dad to help Mark was my husband at the time, to open a bagel store. So we opened this, and my dad taught Mark how to make bagels. And I took a leave of absence from teaching for a while. And then, and it took off. And my dad stayed for a few months. And then Mark and I just kept going, and I never went back to teaching, so we've been here ever since. Well, it was just for people around here. It was, this store used to be half the size, and we just kind of did a little, we didn't even have sandwiches, we just did bagels to go, and we didn't even have coffee back in when we opened in 88. We just had, or 89 it was, we just had canned drinks and bagels to go and cream cheese to go. And then after about maybe 5 to 8 years, we started doing sandwiches, and coffee became big, and we started doing coffee and the nice coffee. So it was really a small town thing, and then it just grew, and then we opened up this side of the store to fit more seating. Customers give them to us. My dad was, he boxed when he was younger, but they just, customers brought them in. And then I just changed all the frames to be black so they would match, but customers would just bring frames and pictures of athletes. Some baseball, some boxing, some, there's some other athletes. Mostly baseball and boxing though, are up there. The Darland,
yes.
That's funny. He came in every single day for like 10 years, and he got a garlic bagel with garlic cream cheese, and he was really Southern. He's from Kentucky, and he would call us all Darland. He'd say, Darland, I want a garlic with garlic. So, and he'd talk really loud. He'd sit at the same table every day. And so then we started calling him Darland. I don't even know what his real name is.
I mean,
I could think about it, I hardly remember, but I never called him his name. And his wife would come with him, and his daughter, she was little, now she's growing, married, and now she still comes in, but, so when he passed away, we made a garlic special, and made a garlic with garlic. And that picture, another customer made it for us and gave it to us. But he was here every single day. And sit at the same table every day. Well, we bake fresh every single morning. We start from scratch every morning. So anything that's left today is going to get bad day old for tomorrow. So tomorrow we sell it at a discount. We buy 2 get 1 free bag. And if not, we just give them out to people. Those baskets in the front will be brand new tomorrow. Every day, those are brand new. And anything's left, we back day.
So every day, it's always a fresh batch.
And Kanishas too. Just you know, improving with the times, staying for as long as I can stay. I'm pretty much at capacity here. To grow anymore here is probably too hard. So I have been thinking about lately maybe getting in, moving into a different place, which I didn't used to think I would ever want to move again, but I'm starting to think I do because we're pretty much at capacity here. So, you know, I want to do this. I still love it. I still love coming to work every day. And I never have a day where I go, oh, I get tired, but I love baking. I love my customers. I love my employees. It's still fun for me, so I want to do it as long as I can. And my customers are like family. They really are.